हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज़ फॉर क्लास 11th सब्जेक्ट इन्फॉर्मेटिक्स प्रैक्टिसेस। स्टूडेंट्स, इन द लास्ट वीडियो यू हैड स्टडीड अबाउट द डिफरेंट कंपोनेंट्स ऑफ कंप्यूटर्स, दैट इज़ द स्टोरेज डिवाइसेस। नाउ इन दिस वीडियो यू विल स्टडी अबाउट द सॉफ्टवेयर। हार्डवेयर पार्ट इज ओवर, नाउ वी विल टॉक अबाउट द सॉफ्टवेयर पार्ट्स। सो लेट अस प्रोसीड। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी टॉक अबाउट व्हाट इज अ सॉफ्टवेयर। So students, software is a set of instructions, data or programs used to operate computers and execute specific tasks. In other words, you can say students that software is a collection of programs or set of instructions which tells the computer what to do and how to do. Another definition is given that a computer software or simply software is a collection of data or computer instructions or computer programs that tell the computer how to work. This is in contrast to physical hardware from which the system is built and actually performs the work. Now I think you have understood the definition of software. Let's proceed to the next, that is types of software. Students, there are mainly two types of software. So here student, the definition of hardware and software both are given. So we talk directly about the two types of software, that is system software and application software. So what is a system software, students? Let's see. System software: a computer is mere a machine that knows nothing of itself. Rather, it requires instructions for each and everything it performs. Means computer does not know anything of its own. For doing any work, it requires instructions, set of instructions. Further, these instructions are provided to it through software. Means the instruction through which computer work, they are provided through the softwares. And the software that control the internal computer operation, that is reading data from input devices, transmitting processed information to the output devices, checking system components, converting data instruction to computer understandable form, all other internal works which are performed by the software, such type of software is known as system software. Listen student, system software is that type of software which performs the internal computer function, internal computer operation, like reading data from input devices, transmitting processed information to the output devices, or checking the system components, etc. Students, there are two types of system software. System software is also categorized, that is of two types: operating system and language processor. Once again, you can see the system software definition here. The software that controls internal computer operation is called system software. So let's first talk about the operating system. What is operating system? Students, you must have heard that operating system is a software, system software, which provides the interface between the user and the computer hardware. Operating system is an interface between the user and the computer hardware. So let's see. The primary goal of an operating system is thus to make the computer system convenient to use. And secondary goal is to use computer hardware in an efficient manner. Listen students, the primary goal of operating system is to make the computer system convenient to use, to make the computer system easy to use. That is the primary goal. A secondary goal is to use computer hardware in an efficient manner. So an operating system is an important component of a computer system which controls all the other components of the computer system. Simply you can say that operating system controls all the other components all the other things of computer system. Here the definition, you can see an operating system is a program which acts as an interface between a user and the hardware. As I told before only, operating system is a program, set of program which acts as an interface between the user and the computer hardware. Students, major components of a computer system which are governed by the operating system are the hardware, the operating system, the application program, routines like compiler, linker, database management system, utility programs, and the humanware, that is user. These are the major components of a computer system. And in all these, the main most important is operating system, where it is telling about each, where hardware provides the basic computing resources. The application program routines define the way in which these resources are used to solve the computing problems of the users. And the operating system that controls and coordinates the use of the hardware among the various application programs for the user, for various users. Another important role of operating system given that an operating system's major role is to execute a program. Whatever programs are executed, whatever the controls and management is done, that is done by the operating system. Here is given OS means operating system is responsible for allocating required resources such as memory, CPU, etc. to a program so that its instruction can be executed by CPU. Means any program, if given to computer, any instruction given to computer, that is processed, its address is allocated by the operating system only. There are different types of operating system available nowadays, like single user operating system, multi user operating system, time sharing operating system, real time operating system, multi processing operating system, distributed operating system. Next system software, that is language processor. A language processor, you can also say a translator. Language processor is a special type of computer software that can translate the source code into an object code or machine code. Now you must be thinking, what is a source code or what is an object code? Let's see what is a source code. A source code refers to the program written by a programmer in a high-level programming language. Means in a high level programming language like C, C++, if a user writes a program, so that program or code is known as source code. Object code refers to a code usually in machine language or binary code, a language that computer can understand easily and run on hardware. Means when the source code is converted into object code, then it becomes in the binary form that computer can easily understand. And for converting this only, for converting the source code, means the program in high level language, into the program of machine language, we require translator. Listen students, once again, translator or language processor are most useful or very useful because they only convert the program of high level languages into the program of low level language. That means they only convert the source code of high level language into the object code of machine language, and that's why the computer can understand the program of high level language, because computer understands only binary digits 0 and 1, that is object code. So let's see students, there are three types of translator which can convert the source code into object code, that is assembler, interpreter and compiler. Students, assembler, it is the language processor which converts the program written in assembly language into machine language. Interpreter is also a translator, a system software only, which translates and executes the instructions written in a computer program line by line, unit by unit. Remember this, that interpreter is also a translator which converts the source code of high level language into object code of machine language, but it converts line by line. Compiler is another type of system software which translates and executes instructions written in a computer program in one go only. Means it translates the source code into object code, the whole program at once, in one go only. So the difference you can understand between the interpreter and compiler. What are the differences? That interpreter converts line by line, but compiler converts the whole program at once. Interpreter takes more time, compiler takes less time. Interpreter occupies less memory because it is a small program, but compiler occupies more memory because it's a big program. Now I think you have understood about the language processor. Thank you for today, students. After this, we will talk about application software in the next video on next day. Thank you.